In Premiere Pro, you have this awesome tool called Lumetri Scopes that helps you visualize the brightness and contrast of the clip that is selected. If you don't see Lumetri Scopes at the moment, just head over to Window and choose Lumetri Scopes. Also, make sure you right-click on the Scopes area and make sure Luma is selected under Waveform Type. The Lumetri Scopes panel has some indicators that help you see much easier if the image is overexposed or underexposed. So basically, you need to avoid having pixels peaking at the 100 mark for the highlights or the 0 mark at the bottom for the shadows. If some pixels reach one of these values, it's not really a big deal. But if you can, you should avoid this situation. During this video, I will work with a few different examples of clips that I recorded specifically for this video. Let's take the first example that was recorded here in my room. In this scene, I have a desk that is almost white in the real world and a speaker that is also very close to white. I also have a keyboard and a mouse that are very close to black, so in this case, I will need to have pixels close to the 100 mark in the scopes as well as pixels that are close to the 0 value. On the scopes, you can see that I already have some pixels that are very close to 100, and that's because I have a reflection on the speaker right here in this area. I first bring down the black point using the slider, and you can see how the dark pixels are getting closer to the 0 value. I also take the shadow slider and bring it to the left, and I'm constantly checking the scopes in real time on the left side of the screen, but also the image preview to see what I'm doing. Now let's push up the white parts using this slider until on the scopes I see pixels coming pretty close to the 100 mark. Just make sure you don't push it too hard because you'll start peaking in the highlights. I could just let this clip as it is with a neutral contrast, but I like a more contrasty look. It's a personal preference, by the way. So I can just take the contrast slider and push it to the right. You can instantly see that the objects stand out more, and you also start to see more saturation in the colors, in this case, in the greens. So if you like this look, you can go with this procedure. In this scene, pushing the pixels close to the 100 mark in the highlights was justified because those objects are white in the real world, and the same thing with the black objects. Here you can see a before and after I made the correction of this clip. And now before we continue, if you feel some value in this video, make sure you hit the thumbs up because that will help me. And also tell me in the comments if you usually spend time or not with the color correction. Let's go to the next example now. As you can see in this shot, we don't have any white or black objects, and this thing is reflected in the scopes as well. All the information is somewhere in the middle between 30 and 70. I recorded this shot in the shade, and this is why I need to think more now before adjusting the blacks and especially the whites. I need to create contrast, but I don't need to get close to 100 for the highlights. So let's adjust the black point first, and then the shadows. As you can see, I stopped around the 10 value on the scopes, and that's because the shadows are softer, and I don't necessarily need to have very dark shadows in this case. And because I don't have white objects in the scene, like I said before, I don't need to push the whites and the highlights until they reach 100, because that would be unnatural for this scene. So I will bring back these sliders to 0 and then push them gently to the right until the footage looks natural. If I feel that I need more contrast, I can use the designated slider to make the image more saturated and create, let's say, a more punchy look, a more contrasty look for this image. Here is the before, and here is the after. Again, a pretty significant difference. Okay, the third example is with these leaves that are in focus and the blurred background with other trees behind, but also the sky is visible and some white clouds between those branches. So in this case, I will think again, look at the scopes and ask myself, do I have to push some pixels close to the 100 mark? And the answer is yes, because the clouds are supposed to be almost white. It was a sunny day with a very bright light, and I want to create contrast while still maintaining a natural look. I tried to think back to the moment when I recorded this footage and then tried to replicate that look using the scopes and sliders. I'm adjusting the blacks, the shadow slider, and then I only need to adjust the highlight slider to insert some more brightness in the scene. I am not touching the white slider because if I choose to push it to the right, you can see on the scopes on the left side of the screen that I start to see more and more pixels peaking in the highlights. And I want to avoid that. So I will bring this slider back to zero. Let's increase the contrast a bit more. And at this point, I really like it. Here is the before, a very washed out look if you want. And here is the after, a natural and pleasing scene. And now, after you learned how to color correct, I recommend you to watch this video next to me where I explain how to color grade your footage to obtain a more cinematic look. So, thank you so much for watching. I'm Chris, and see you in the next video.